this is not a personal session of franchise mode, so I'm going to be picking a team that is not the Boston Bruins. And one thing that we need to think about is, do we want to be a rebuilding team or a champion team? But we're going to have a few minutes to think about that, and I know you guys aren't going to have any say in that, since it's going to happen in about 5 minutes. But first off, we have to enter our GM name. And I like to come up with some funny names. Let's go. One thing I like to do is I'll look around me and I'll find an object. I think I got one. Alright, I gotta think how I want to spell this. So, I don't know. So, I'll tell you right now while I struggle to figure out how I want to spell this. Object I found was a clothespin, and I'm trying to figure out how I can spin that off like the name Claude, because a lot of French Canadians have the name Claude spelled C-L-A-U-D-E, I think. Yep, Claude. So I was wondering if I could skip the D, go Clo, and then make a last name spin. Spin. I guess that kind of works. Alright, we're gonna go. Our name is Close Spin. I think that one kind of worked. Okay, we'll continue. Now we need to find our team. So we could base it specifically based off of the budget or the arena. $72 million per season. Let's see here. They have a pretty medium-aged arena, probably getting old. The owner's personality, he is very middle about whether he wants to spend money. Success is medium important to him, and he's pretty patient. But me personally, I don't like. personality of the owner, the most important thing to him is success. But the Sabres are a rebuilding team. But they do have Jack Eichel as well. Success. It is mostly related to Tyler Seguin. If you don't know anything about hockey, Tyler Seguin is a very good young player who originally played for the Boston Bruins, but he's kind of a party kid, and we traded him to Dallas, but I still like him. That's why I kind of like Dallas, and he's very electrifying when he plays. So we will keep moving. Detroit. I'm going to skip Detroit solely because a lot of their players are veterans, and they do have a couple good young players, but most of their players are very old in the hockey world, like in their 30s, which is not old in the normal world. And their arena is also old. Okay, Edmonton has a brand new arena, 0 years old. They also have very good young players like Connor McDavid and Ryan Nugent-Hopkins. And this game's listing Milan Lucic as their top player, which seems a little weird because he's like, I mean, he's good and he's not bad at all. of young and old players. They have very good prospects that their potential is very high to be good. Their arena isn't super old, but their owner's personality is not the best. The LA Kings don't play in a super old arena, but their players are getting a little old. Their owner is willing to spend money, and he likes success, and he's pretty patient as well. So their owner is pretty good. Their players are getting a little old, though. We'll keep moving. Minnesota, I would say that their players are also getting kind of old. Though, like Eric Halla. The Montreal Canadiens, as a Bruins fan, I would be killed before I picked the Montreal Canadiens. Just saying. We will keep moving. Though they do have a very good goalie. The Nashville Predators, I do enjoy watching them. They have a very good defense, but a lot of their players are fairly old, or they are veterans. So I will keep moving. The New Jersey Devils have potential, but a lot of their players are veterans, and they need to work on getting younger. So we will keep moving. Very young arena. It's only 4 years old. And they have a pretty good mix. I would say they have more veterans than young players, but they do have a bunch of good young players. But their owner is not really willing to spend money, which could be a problem. We will keep moving. The New York Rangers have a very old arena in Madison Square Garden. And their team is fairly old when it comes to the age of their players. So we will keep moving. The Ottawa Senators have a medium-aged arena at 20 years old. Most of their players, I would say, are veterans or about to become veterans in the coming years. If I had to guess, most of them are around 29 or 30 years old. And in the world of hockey, that's about the prime for a player. And once they reach like 32, they start to get a little bit worse. And when I play GM mode, I normally try to trade them as they turn 30. Keep my team young, so we will keep moving. The Philadelphia Flyers arena is pretty average across the board. Their players are fairly young, I would say. They do. The top players listed at the bottom there are all veterans. Voracek is still pretty young, but a lot of their players are young, and they also have a very good prospect pool. So we'll keep them in mind. So let's remember, we have the Colorado Avalanche. I'm having trouble remembering the middle one that I thought of. And the Philadelphia Flyers. I'm sure I can figure it out if I went back up. Next we have the Pittsburgh Penguins. They have a fairly new arena in Console Energy Center, which in real life just got its name changed to PPG Paints Arena, I think. They're obviously the most recent Stanley Cup winner, if you follow hockey at all. But I feel like their players are sort of aging a lot. They're getting past their prime. A lot of their players are getting over that 30-year-old mark that I like to avoid. So we're just going to keep going. The San Jose Sharks do have some young players, but they also have a lot of veterans that are older than average veterans. A lot of 35 and up year old players. So we will keep going. The St. Louis Blues have a pretty even mix of young and old players. They have an average success importance and a very medium patience amount. The only thing patience is going to affect, I think, is whether they're going to fire us if we don't do what they like. So managers or owners with a higher patience will not fire us immediately. I'm just going to skip over Tampa. The Toronto Maple Leafs, I would say, have a mix of young and old players. In real life, they are rebuilding, so they have made the, I'm trying to think of the words here, they're not coming to me. They're actually trying in real life to acquire more younger players and acquire more prospects. So in this game, they will have more prospects, but a lot of their current roster, their current NHL roster, is still veterans, so we're just going to skip over the Maple Leafs here. Vancouver, I would call them a fairly old team, a veteran team, so we're going to keep going. And the Washington Capitals, I would also say they have a fairly even mix of young and old players, but I would say that most of their superstars are older, so we will keep going. And then I think this is the last of 30 teams. We have the Winnipeg Jets. They have a fairly young arena. I would say that they have a split veteran and young player roster. But their owner does not have the best personality. He's a little lacking on the spending. So we will not pick them either. And we're back to the top. So I think what we have as our possibilities. So we have the, where did they go, the Colorado Avalanche. I have to find the middle one. The Edmonton Oilers, which I think we're going to skip solely for the fact that I did do a GM mode with them recently in my free time, so I'm going to skip them. So our two options are the Colorado Avalanche and the Philadelphia Flyers. So let's look at them. Flyers, like I said, have a good prospect pool, especially on defense. Their arena is not really a problem in its age. Their personality, if their owner really wants to spend money and really likes success, but we could get fired. I'm not super worried about getting fired, though. If we go back up to the Colorado Avalanche, wherever they went, there we go. About in its age. They have a lot of good young players that are already on the NHL roster. So with the Flyers, they do have good young players on their roster, but a lot of them are in their prospect pool and not playing in the NHL yet. And with the Colorado Avalanche, they have a lot of young players who are in the NHL already. But their owner is not as good when it comes to spending and success importance. So, this is where I need to make a decision. Colorado Avalanche or Philadelphia Flyers. Let me go back and look at the Flyers. One off. Okay. I think that I'm going to pick the Philadelphia Flyers solely because their facility ratings are slightly higher and it won't cost as much to fix the facility, and their budget is higher. I think I can spend, the owner is letting me spend $3 million more on player salaries, and that is very helpful. So, that's who we're going to choose, Philadelphia Flyers. Alright, here we got to look at some settings here. So owner mode, we're going to keep on, enables features such as budgets, revenue, relocation, owner goals, GM firing, promotions, and more. CPU trades, yes, that will let the computer, the other 29 teams trade between themselves without me being part of it. Auto finances allows the CPU to manage your franchise's finances and budget. We want that off, so we have to do it. The fantasy draft, I know somebody wanted me to do a fantasy draft, since we spent so much time looking at which team we're going to pick, we're going to keep that off. Morale meetings, we're going to keep this on. It's just gives us the possibility of increasing our players' morale by giving them advice and stuff like that. Except relocation, the owner will always authorize your initial attempt to relocate the franchise. We will keep that off. The salary cap, we're going to keep that on. Waivers, we will keep that on. Auto-sign free agents off. GM firing, yes. Assistant coach edits lines, we will turn that off. And we will continue. Okay, so let's go to advanced settings. This is what I think we're going to do. Normally I play on 25 years as the GM mode. But since I'm going to be filming this, I'm going to do 5 years. Only 5 years. And I plan or hope to do 1 year, 1 season per video. So it should be 5 videos, hopefully. And then we can do another team, and that way you guys will be able to choose which team we play as. So we're just going to do 5 seasons, keep it short. If we did 25 seasons, it would take a long time. And I think everything else is where I want it. Trade difficulty on medium seems fine. I could turn it up to hard. You know what? We're going to keep it on hard. That's where we're going to start our career. Keep it on. Keep the salary cap on. Oh, yeah. So, if anybody has watched the entire thing, I would be surprised because I feel like a lot of people are going to get bored watching that. But if anybody like me is out there watching, they were probably really interested in all of that, but I don't expect you guys to be. That's not an issue. Okay, there we go. So we are loaded up, and if we look in the top right corner above where my cursor is, we have a 91 overall offense, a 90 overall defense, and an 89 overall goalie rating. That is not bad, but it's also kind of average when it comes to good teams. So, if I show you guys the calendar, where we are when we start is we're going to be right in front of the preseason. So the preseason starts tomorrow in this game. That's not a bad thing, but it's also not great because we don't have much time to beef up our team at all. Also, on the bottom, I'm getting a little icon that says I need to fix something about our arena over here. So we will just look into that really fast, and hopefully it won't cost you much. So, where it is? It's bathrooms. Okay, so our bathrooms need maintenance, and it's going to cost us $262,000, so we're just going to do it, because the season's about to start, and all of these are still good. Pretty much everything's at 100%. This is mostly, right now, is not for every season, but specifically for the first season of a career. You kind of need to make everything the way you want it, so go into our budget really fast. This is kind of boring, but I'm going to do it. We're just going to go to marketing budget. budget, we will turn... We're going to turn season ticket advertising up to 40%. And the only reason I do that is because at the end of the season, we start advertising for season tickets. And it's just annoying to keep changing it, so I just have it set as that all the time. Now for the operations budget. We want our fans to like us, so we're going to spend, let's say, $2 million on advertising. We want to give our fans some promotions. So let's see, the minimum we can spend on them is $730, and the max is $1,200, or $1.2 million. So let's just spend $900, a little over $900,000 on them, on promotions, and we're going to put everything else to arena operations. And the reason I do that is because what I just fixed, like I fixed the bathrooms, that stuff gets expensive, and then the arena starts getting crappier, and the fans don't like it as much. So, we're just gonna keep most of the money in the arena operations. So we will save our budget. And I think we're good. Let's see, I think we're good there. Nope, I don't want to exit the main menu. Okay, so our owner happiness is amazing. Obviously, he just hired us. Next, so manage our roster, and we're just going to see what our lines look like. Actually, this is what I like to do. So I go into roster moves, and I like to just look at this. So as you see, we have 6 centers in the NHL right now, 4 left wings, 4 right wings. So what that tells me is we have left wings and right wings covered. So why would we need 6 centers? So we can send 2 of these guys down to the AHL. Now this is where it gets complicated, since both of these guys have the same overall rating. Now I'm pretty sure Pierre-Edward Belmar is a lot younger than Nick Cousins. No, he is 31 years old. I thought he was very young. Okay. He still might be younger. Wow, he's not. Okay. I was completely wrong there. So, when it comes to them being the same overall rating, I normally go off of age, unless it's pretty close, and then I'll go off what type of center they are, or what type of position they play. So, our AHL roster looks like this now for centers and left wings. You see, we have some good prospects here. So, Belmar's pretty old. Is still pretty young. Left wings, Chris Connor's old. That guy's young. Alright, so. And that guy's old, so. In the NHL, our defense is not great. We'll put it that way. So, in 86 overall, with Shane Gostisbehere's Bears in 86 overall, that is pretty much a second line defenseman. So, we technically have 0 first-line defensemen, but what that means is we're just going to be playing Shane Gostisbehere and probably Mark Strait on our first line, and then Rad Gudas and Michael Delzato can play on the second line, and Nick Schultz and Andrew McDonald can play on the third line, and Brandon Manning will keep him in the NHL as a backup for injury purposes. Now, as you can tell, if you look at the salary, Andrew McDonald is old. He's 30 years old. He's earning $5 million a season, while Nick Schultz is old, but he's the same overall rating, making almost, actually more than half that Andrew McDonald is making. So if cap space becomes a problem, you see down in the left-hand corner we have 1.7 left. If cap space is an issue, we can just send Andrew McDonald down to the minor league, and we won't have to pay the $5 million, which is great. But, so here's where the Philadelphia Flyers is going to get interesting. So Shane Gostisbehere is young. He's 23 years old. Mark Strait is old, 38 years old. Rad Gudas is medium age, 26. Michael Delzato is also pretty medium. Nick Schultz and Andrew McDonald, we already looked at them. They are old. Brandon Manning is medium. But in the system, 78 overall. So he's only 2 overall less than our backup right now. But he's a lot younger. So Hag, Provorov is 19 years old. He's a very good prospect. And I thought they had more, but actually Morin is also young. And that guy's not. So we have a lot of defensive prospects. And when it comes to goalies, Steve Mason is not bad, 88 overall, and he's only earning $4 million this season, which is not bad for somebody who's that good. Normally an 88 overall would be earning between $6 and $7 million a season. And Michael Neuwirth, as a backup, is very good, 84 overall. And in the system, we have, I believe it's Anthony Stolarz, who's 22 years old and already a 79 overall. So he's probably going to get pretty good. So, like I was saying, we have some good prospects. Let me just check. So that's good. And we have 6 and a backup there. We have 4 there. So we have our first line, right wing, Jake Voracek, 90 overall. Second line, right wing, Wayne Simmonds, 88, is very good. Third line, Braden Schend, 87. Now, if you don't play this game, you probably don't know about this, but pretty much what you want to do, because it's easier to fit into the salary cap, because players who are better want to earn more money. Your first line center, or your first line player, in a perfect world, is going to be around an 89 or higher. So we have that. And then our second liner, we probably want like an 86. And then our third liner, like an 84. And fourth liner, between like an 80 and an 82. So we have very good second and third liner. And like I said, our third liner potentially could be an 84. And right now our third liner is all the way up at 87. So on right wing, we are very, very strong. But if we look at these lines, our number one left wing is only an 83, not an 89 or higher. So what we might need to do is trade a player like Wayne Simmonds, who's getting old. He's only 28, but Jake Voracek, I think, is younger. Yep. And he's also better. And Braden Schend is younger. So we trade a guy like Wayne Simmonds. We would get an 84, potentially, at right wing back. And we would trade a guy like Matt Reed, who's old, and we would get a way better left wing in the trade. Now, Scott Layton is very young and very good. Michael Raffle, I don't think, is very old. He's medium age. Boyd Gordon, I think, is getting old. Yeah, but as a fourth line player, that doesn't really matter. So if we could upgrade Matt Reed for a guy like Wayne Simmonds, get rid of Wayne Simmonds, could be good. Okay. Now on center, we have a very good center in Claude Giroux. The only issue when it comes to Claude Giroux is how much he's earning per season, $8.2 million. That's pretty high, especially if a guy like Chris Van Velde gets better and wants to earn like $2.5 a season. And Sean Couturier is going to want more next season, or whenever his contract runs out. I don't know when that is, but he's going to want more. But for centers and right wings, we definitely have a good 1-2 punch. And our center and right wing, when it comes to left wings, we definitely need to upgrade that. And our defense, we have a lot of prospects, but we also have a lot of old players, and they're not great. So we will go best lines with the players in right now. Good edit lines. And as you can see here, turn off, okay. So as you can see, Wayne Simmonds is on the left wing, but if you look to the right, he is a right wing. Remember, we saw that. So on the right wing, if we played right wings on the right wing and left wings on the left wing, we would have Jake Voracek and then Wayne Simmonds and then Braden Schend. But the game agrees with me, and it thinks we should have Jake Voracek, then Braden Schend, and it thinks Wayne Simmonds can be the number one left wing, which we were going to do a trade anyway, him for a better left wing, and then he'd be playing the right position. So right now we have wing, then a left wing, then a left wing, then a left wing, and center, 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 which means Boyd Gordon, who's a left wing, is also playing on the right wing. But another thing we want to look at is if you look under the player's name, you will see under Claude Giroux, we have playmaker. And if you don't know anything about the game, I will just explain this to you really fast. There are different positions. Like if I go to different players, they all have different things. Like, so a playmaker is going to be somebody who sets up a play. He's going to have a lot of assists in a season. He could have a lot of goals, but that's not his, he's not a shooting player. He's a passing player. So on this top line, we have two playmakers. Now, these two players have good chemistry, but that doesn't really fall into place in this game. And we don't, and they are good players, 91 and 90 overall. So, and Wayne Simmonds is a two-way forward. What that means is he is a forward, but instead of, like, trying to score goals, he actually does score a lot of goals. But as a two-way forward, you really focus on playing defense as well, not just playing offense, if that makes sense to you. So he will play offense, but instead of waiting to get a pass, he will go back and help the defenders take the puck from the other team. So Sean Couturier is also a two-way forward, and Braden Schenn's a two-way forward, and Matt Reed is a sniper. So a sniper is a shooter, obviously. A grinder is somebody who is going to be hitting a lot of players, and pretty much their main goal is just to get the puck from the other team. Boyd Gordon's also a grinder, playmaker, and two-way. So that's not all of the player types, but in a perfect world, your lines would have a playmaker, a sniper, and one other thing. I normally like a playmaker, a sniper, and a two-way forward. But what I can do is I could go in and I could look at the, see the stars in the bottom right-hand corner under the player's name. So Claude Giroux has very good puck skills, so he's good at playmaking. But he also has 5 stars in shooting, so he's also good at shooting. And Jacob Voracek has the same thing. So what that could mean, but I think he has the same skating as well. So what I can do is I can go into the settings and change the player type for one of these two guys. I can make one of them a sniper. So I'd probably want to change Jake Voracek to a sniper. Now this is getting very, very in-depth. My throat is actually starting to hurt. But we're going to keep going. We're going to get the season done. So I don't think we're going to change much. We can look at our defense really fast. Also, on defense, there is offensive defenseman, as you see under Shane Gostisbehere, and defensive defenseman, and two-way defenseman. Okay, so two-way defensemen, their job is they're mostly trying to turn over the puck, while defensive defensemen are trying to shut down the guy who has the puck, if you can kind of think about the difference there. So, you either want a offensive defenseman and a defensive defenseman, or offensive and offensive, those don't line up, but offensive and two-way would work, or offensive or defensive and two-way would work as well. Pretty much you just don't want two of the same on one line. Now we have we have 3 offensive defensemen, 2 defensive defensemen, and a two-way defender. Those 3 guys shoot left. Okay, so we have 5 left-handed shots and 1 right-handed shot in Radko Gudas. So what we can do here, if we want this to be perfect, we can put, let's see here, we'll put Andrew McDonald instead of Michael Delzato. That'll give us offensive on the left and defensive two-way defensive on the right. That doesn't really matter. It's probably going to change when people start getting injured anyway. So, and we will just check morale really fast. I'm trying to get this over with. Okay, so nobody needs to talk to me. That's good. And we will just go into captains and jerseys really fast. Claude Giroux is our captain. Wayne Simmonds is an assistant, and Mark Streit is an assistant. Now, if you remember Mark. work straight's getting pretty old, so we're going to have to keep making sure with that. So, that's all we needed to do in there. That was very in-depth, and we probably didn't have to do all of that, but that's what I like to do. Okay. So, we're finally going to play a game. We're going to go into calendar, and we're going to simulate through the preseason. After our last preseason game. Okay. Close bin. It's a new season, so let's get down to business. I have set goals for the upcoming season that I would like you to accomplish. Have a look to ensure you are clear on my expectations. Remember, I will be evaluating you based on how well you perform in these goals. Okay, so this is what the owner is telling us. State of the team is important. We are a hopeful team. As a playoff hopeful, I expect us to compete for a playoff spot. However, if we don't make the playoffs, we need to ensure our fans are happy with the direction of the team. What that means is, it's okay if we don't make the playoffs. However, we need to be getting better. Our primary goal is to get 41 sellouts to establish home ice. In my experience with franchise mode, unless you win a lot of games, you're probably not going to get 41 sellouts. Secondary goals. The owner wants us to win the regular season home opener and expects us to boost fan happiness to at least 92, which could be difficult. So if we don't get those goals, it's not the end of the world. But if we go like three seasons and we don't get any of those goals, he's probably going to fire us instead of offering us a better contract. Okay, we're just simulating through preseason. We're going to edit our scouting assignment. Let's go to the WHL. We'll scout forwards for 6 weeks. Alright, we already allocated our budget, so we're good there. We're just going to auto-assign promotion nights. We'll let them do that for us. So we started off the preseason pretty good. 2-0, 3-0. Matt Reed got injured. 4-0. 5-0. 5-1. And that's fine. Okay, 6-1-0. That is a very good preseason, but normally preseason has no reflection on how you do in the regular season. So we already, what I would do at this point is I would go in and if it'll load, there we go. I would just look at stuff in here and make sure we're good. Make sure we're not putting, make sure we don't have too many players in the NHL and stuff like that. But we've already done that. So what we're gonna go now, I'm not gonna make any trades right now. I'll save that for the off season. But I'm just going to look at free agents, see if there's anybody that I can afford that will make our team better. It's not likely. So, there is an 85 right wing, but if you remember, we have a very good right wing and very good centers. A defenseman now, Medvedev, is better than two of our defensemen. He would be fourth best on our team, I think. But he is old, and we don't have quite $2 million to give him, so we're just gonna pass on that. We don't need Kyle Quincy, Sam Gagne, we don't need him, we have good centers. Right or left wing, we already have a bunch of 82 overall left wings, so we don't need him. What I'm seeing from this is we don't need anybody, maybe just look at a goalie. I think we only have a couple in the franchise, so if we can find young goalies like Ortio, right here. I think I want to give Ortio a contract because he's only 25 years old. He's currently a backup, or his role is a backup. And I've played with him in previous sessions of franchise mode, and he's not bad. So let's see here. I don't want to give him a 7-year contract. I don't really want to give him any money at all either. Let's see if we'll take $1 million. I don't have that much. Let's see 70. We're going to pass on him. 73, but he's 24. 25-year-old 75 isn't horrible, but we just offered Ordeo, who's 25-year-old 81. So we will just see what Ordeo says and be done with it. So. Let's try to simulate. Okay. We will simulate all the way up to this game versus Anaheim. Alright, best lines. Okay, Ordeo accepted our offer, which I'm very happy about. Okay, but our backup goalie did not like that. Michael Neubert, because he is considered a backup, and we just acquired another guy who is a backup, so he thinks we are trying to replace him, which we're not. We're just trying to ensure our longevity. Okay, amateur scout says, in general, it's going to be a good year for rookies, so what that means is we want to keep our draft picks. Okay, so our record right now, I believe, is 1-1-1. Go best lines. Okay, so as you can tell, if you look, so each date that we have a game has the other team's logo, and then it says either versus their name or the at symbol, and versus means it's a home game, at means it's an away game, and if you remember, it was one of our goals from the owner to win our home opener, and this is the first home opener. This is where the regular season started, right here versus LA. So this is the first home game, so if we win this, then we get a goal. We completed our goal. If we lose this, we did not. So I'm just going to sim the game, which pretty much gives me control over everything. So I'm just going to sim the whole period, sim the first period. Okay, so they scored 2 and we scored 1, and I'm going to sim the second period. Okay, the score is 5-2. That's not good. So I'm going to intervene, which means I'm going to be playing the game. Okay, you see we're better than Anaheim in overall in every category except for defense. So we need to score 3 goals to tie it, and I don't think that that's going to happen on pro difficulty. But I'm going to start the game on pro difficulty and see how I can do. Because if I turn it to rookie difficulty, I think I could score 3 goals in probably 30 seconds to a minute, and that's not really fair. If I kept the whole third period, the score would probably be like 10-5, and we win.
Two teams have played hard through so, 2, and we begin period 3.
We will try it on pro mode.
Anaheim's in their own end, hoping to make a play to center.
Trying to control it vibrating a lot. Sorry if you can hear
possession
that.
Still as he moves up the wing. Near the blue line to Fowler. Outstanding point blank save.
With this puck being so close to that, this is all a reactionary save.
Got on by with that one, and it's driven away. Looking to Silverberg. Oh, and that one won't go.
He's had a number of real good scoring opportunities, but he can't score. That's why his team trails.
No! What a chance! Pulls his way along. Quick shot from the point. Big save. Solid work there by Horan. That shot came from right in front. They're back to within 2 now.
Put it on rookie mode. So that's 1 down. It was a battle in front of the net. That's what's called a dirty goal.
There is still time. Thus, there is still hope. It's a good thing. Anaheim's got another face-off win. To Kessler.
Kessler's effort on that last goal was unbelievable.
Let's it go. Turned aside.
We're gonna need some good defense.
Puck is grabbed by Shan.
Because scoring goals doesn't matter if we let them get just as many. That was close. Oh, he's gonna let me have it.
Taken over again. Puck is thrown to Votnin.
All right. I apologize if I'm not talking very much. That's purely focus based.
Possession taken by Couturier.
Enormous hit.
Well, guys, he didn't see him coming until the last minute. That's a pretty solid contact.
On to Cogliano.
Gonna get some payback for that.
Into the attacking end. Pass cut. Passing one off now to Vandeveld.
There's Vandeveld. Here we go. Nope. Oh,
that puck's
good,
loose.
Good. Yeah. The referee's waving that one off. He thinks I interfered with the goalie. I would like to argue, but since it's a video game, it might be considered interference because I think I did run through the goalie. I think he's good. That's close. I don't think that's a bad goal, but the game only recognizes it as, I mean, it's a code, like, written into a computer, so if the game thinks that I hit the goalie, it's either yes he did or no he didn't. There's no, like, factors that go into it. So, we'll figure that one out. Hopefully it goes our way. Let's see. He's gonna call it no goal. Okay. So he thinks I messed with the goalie too much there. Wow, that's really glitchy. Okay. Obviously, if that was real world, it probably would have counted, but that's not an issue. Oops.
The Ducks win the draw. What's next?
Oh,
Anaheim's in possession in neutral ice. And he dumps
it in. Nick Schultz is slow. He's also holding his ground.
And the arm of the referee comes up. A penalty.
Okay, they got a penalty for that hit, so.
Gains the blue line. Mason's at the bench.
Keep possession.
And the puck controlled by Schultz. Hammers one. No time to react. Didn't need it. Save.
Get possession.
Score goals, you have to go to
the. I could have kept possession.
You gotta find a way to put it in the.
My guy wouldn't move towards the puck. He's just
standing for elbowing.
Which is pretty annoying.
This has been a power play that's gotten a lot of times, but no goals. Maybe
start
with
that face off.
To strike.
Oh,
that one hit someone on the way.
No. Don't sit possession. Jerk.
The Ducks in control of the puck.
Stealing is bad. Didn't your parents teach you that?
Gathered up by Strike.
I thought that was a bad guy. We both wearing like the same colors. Just.
Puck corralled by Kessler.
So, out of like. In my peripheral vision, it's hard to tell.
And he gains the
zone.
What
team?
Around through the corner. A shot. Good chance. Denied. That is one solid keep, and play can continue. Puck settled down by Voracek.
Oh, come on, Voracek.
Can't get it on net. On, what a great job of getting it out.
All right, power play's over. That's a
back at full strength. The Flyers have possession in their own end. Propelled to Giroux.
Okay.
Gains the zone and looks over his options.
Crossbar.
Got the iron with the shot. Moving it to Silverberg.
Got this. Let's get possession
the Ducks
back.
Are out of their own end. Snapping a pass to Silverberg.
I want to either.
Good shooting place. That's a good pad save. To Silverberg.
Come on.
Terrific luck save, but it's loose. Philadelphia's in their own end, continuing on.
Powered through there.
Knocks
wow.
It away with the stick. Really?
Stay outside. Oh my gosh.
You guys together
my guys
with
would get outside in time.
Whoa, pick yourself up after that one. That is a big hit.
Fires a
right,
shot.
Good job, Mason.
Oh, tremendous save.
Let's
tonight
go
a terrific
flat footed. Get past him just like that.
Shoots.
Oh, come on.
Wonderful save. What skill by both goalie and shooter.
You want to score goals, you have to go to this area.
And he fires!
Okay,
score!
I wasn't trying to score there, but it turned
one.
Out to work. Got a deflection in front of the goal, and worked in our favor. So, we have 4 minutes and 21 seconds game time to score 1 more goal to tie it, 2 more to win it. We can always go for overtime, but
that puck looked like
it's
he
obviously
got
preferable
right
to win
front of the
it
goaltender.
In
I'm sure
regulation.
Had a much better look at that.
It got a nice tip in front of the goal.
At it on the replay right here, you're going to see the goalie's in position, but because
referee
the puck is deflected the way it was, it gets past him in a way he just can't react to.
All right.
To Garvin.
Garvin's got to stay disciplined here. He's had a boatload of penalties here. This game is too close to take another bad penalty.
Oh, come on. You're going to get hit like that. I got to get possession.
it on to Schultz. Philadelphia's up the wing, settling things. Loose puck, solid defensive play there.
Good try there, Lee.
Cut through the neutral zone. Gets across, looks over his options. Great stick there.
My gosh, it's really hard to tell these colors.
Back there. Left wing.
Peripheral vision does not show the difference.
Tries to get it on there.
Both orange, black, and white.
Arrest.
Face off. It's an important part of the game. Alright.
The Ducks move to center.
Good poke check. Gotta get that possession back though.
Pitching it to the exit.
Come on. Come on, get possession. 1 minute left.
Slides it to the point to Kessler. Save. We are in the 60th minute out of 60. Gets in and he'll look over his options. Outstanding save with a glove.
I'm gonna be a weenie. And I'm going to put it on rookie mode. Only because... I don't know if it went to the right settings. Yeah, that'll work. Only because it's part of the owner goal, and I don't want to get fired, so... Hopefully I can score 2 goals in 46 seconds. Should be able to. Let's go with forward line 2.
Pitching this one to Richie.
Okay.
Good intercept.
Thank you.
Maintaining possession up the wing.
See, in rookie mode, I can pretty much just walk past him.
Forcing the goalie to crane left and then right. Shifts to the backhand and shoots. Not on the net.
They're not going
to
get a better chance than that down by one.
Terrific save. Terrific opportunity.
Getting late in the game here. Going to need possession. Really going to need that possession.
Terrific save.
If I lose on rookie mode, I'm going to be pretty upset. The only time I ever lose on rookies is because I can't freaking get possession. And it's going to happen again. Really sucks that it just happened on camera.
They can't find the target.
You don't understand how disappointing
that is. That's the hockey game. The game is ended.
The only time I ever lose on rookies is when I don't get possession.
It was a close one, but they
which really sucks. They gave Anaheim all the stars in the game. Well, the good news is we're not going to get fired right away, but it'll happen eventually. Alright, we got this. Failed. Okay, yep, great. Got it, I know. Alright, so now we're just going to simulate all the way to March 1st, which is the trade deadline. Some stops along the way for scouts and such and injuries and just like that one. Okay, so our record is 1-3-1, which is not great. Not great at all. We'll build on that. We'll come back. Don't worry. Sorry about that, just dinging the microphone. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to keep hitting best lines. That way, the assistant coach just does whatever is best. Okay, time again. We will look at his player info. And he's 26 years old and only a 77, so we're going to decline his services. Simulation is the part that's not as fun. You know what? We have plenty of forwards. Let's get a defenseman. Alright. Boop, boop, This is the part we just want to go a lot faster, but doesn't normally go as fast as you would like it. Well, we have a positive record now, 8-6-2. We'll try to keep that up, hopefully. And, yep, a 4-game winning streak. See if we can continue that. Obviously not, as I just said, we were on a 4-game winning streak. I have the unique quality to jinx things, so. Streak. Watch. Watch this. Told you I jinxed it. Wow, we're on a 1-game losing streak. Yep, called it. Jinxed it again. Jinxed our losing streak. Till it ended. Okay. We still have a positive record. We actually have a pretty good record. 14-8-5 is pretty good for considered to be, people are expecting us to be potentially making the playoffs, but they're not going to be mad if we don't, so the fact that our record is 17-9-5 is pretty good. Uh-oh, best player just got injured for, I think, 3 months. Unfortunate. Edit our scouting assignment. Let's go to the OHL and we'll scout forwards for 6 weeks. The NHL games, like NHL 15. This simulation would take a heck of a lot longer. When the NHL games got to the current gen consoles, they got a lot faster. Alright, on our trading block, we have our next 2 first round draft picks. We're going to take those off. Mark Streit, we're going to keep on, even though he's still usable. He's earning a lot of money and he's old. Let's see, he's 39 years old, so he might even retire after this year. So if anybody wants him, they can have him. Let's see, anybody else we want to trade? We're gonna put Wayne Simmonds on the trade block, and I guarantee we'll get some offers on Wayne Simmonds. But hopefully, I'll try to hold off trades till the off season. But if I get something amazing, I'm not going to turn it down. If I get an offer of something that I want, like a left wing, I probably won't turn it down. Okay. So, our arena needs 2 fixes. So, I'm looking for, wow, I'm tired, I'm yawning now. I'm looking for can start doing construction the day before a home game. But if the team is going on a three-game road trip or something, I'm planning for then. I feel like that's kind of smart, so. All right, during this month, if you look, the San Jose game, that's a week from today. After that, we have about a week and a half where we're not playing at home. So we'll fix our arena during that time. All right, let's get some wins. All right. All right, and we'll stop the simulation right there. Best lines. Okay. See, now we have a 7 things to upgrade, so perfect timing. But it is going to be expensive, so. Okay, repair our concessions, repair team store, repair the parking lot. Let's see here, repair lower bowl. We have plenty of money left, so I'll just repair this now. I'm sure everything needs to be repaired. But we have plenty of cash. Alright, everything's getting repaired. Good thing we're going away for 10 days. Okay. We will again simulate to the trade deadline. I wonder if yawning is contagious by just hearing. Should be coming back very, very soon. Almost at the trade deadline here. We're doing good as of winning. Alright, yep, that's still good. Okay, so it's now the trade deadline. We have won. Holy crap, we won. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 games in a row. And now that I've said that, we are going to lose the next 15,000. That's okay. So, currently we are in the playoffs, but we are not guaranteed a spot yet, obviously. We're doing pretty good, though, in the playoffs. So, nope, that's not what I wanted to do. Let's just look at our player stats and make sure nobody is severely underperforming. If anybody's severely underperforming, we might trade them. But we'll probably just be fine, so... So, Claude Giroux has 31 points in 32 games. Sean Couturier has 36 points in 62 games. 28 points in 52 as like a fourth line center. That's pretty good. 16 points. That's not great, but whatever. Okay. All right. Centers are fine. A fourth liner, I'm not worried about. And the defense, which is good. The one thing you can look at is plus minus. If you don't know what that is every time you're on the ice when a goal is scored for your team, you get a plus. And every time you're on the ice when a goal is scored against your team, you get a minus. So we only have two plus players and an even player down here, which is something to be worried about. So, but I'm not going to worry about trading anybody on the trade deadline. We're just going to see how far we get into the playoffs. I'm not expecting to win the Stanley Cup, and I'm not worried about winning it or not. Not this season. So let's simulate to the day after the season ends. And we will see what our record is then. Okay. So we've sold about 80%, a little over 80% of our seats. We can set our ticket prices. And I'm just going to auto-assign all. And we're good there. And we already messed with our marketing budget. Remember I said when during the end of the season this would come up. So we're all good when it comes to the marketing budget. We're already spending 40% of our budget on season ticket advertising. Alright. So remember how I said we were on the 8-game winning streak and then we were going to lose. We lost the game after, just like I said. Since then, we are 1-3. 1 loss, 3 wins. There's more neck cracking. My neck is getting heavy. Alright, best roster. Let's just keep going. Finish her up. So many injuries, come on. All right, best lines. Getting some wins, that's not bad. Season for what we are expected to do, so I think we should be happy with that. All right, ooh, a 9-2 loss. That's unfortunate, but we can bounce back. All right, let's get a couple wins here at the end. Final stretch here, boys. Let's get her done. Finish her strong. Okay, I just realized something that's not very good at all. Address that soon. Alright, good finish of the season. So 46 wins is not bad. And if we go back here, we'll probably find out that we did make the playoffs, I think. Yes, we did make the playoffs. But the one thing that I just saw that is not good at all. First off, there's a morale thing. Mark Streit. I feel like the locker room is a dysfunctional family. We may need a shakeup. Luckily, you're 39 and we don't need you. Come on. Alright, so the key for... So the way these conversations work. Wow. I think I may have just died a little bit in my brain. Okay. The way these conversations work is they say something and we have four options to say back, and then they'll either lose confidence or lose morale, gain morale, or have no effect. So what I found is to just go with the demanding option, and it pretty much works every time. Okay, looks like Mark Streit responded favorably to your strong tone. Okay, the one thing that I just saw, which is not good at all, you see the green smiley faces under morale, MRL, morale. The green happy faces. If I like go over to defense, you see how these like, so these guys aren't as happy as these guys and stuff like that. Well, this guy who I just picked up, remember he was an 81 when I got him. Well, he's not too happy right now. And the less morale they have, the less their overall is. So if he was happier with me, he would be a better player. So that's kind of sucky. Sellouts, like I said, it's not very normal. So okay, the way I simulate playoff games is I will simulate the first four, or I will simulate three games and up to the fourth game, but not play the fourth game. That way, the way it works is you need to lose four games to get out or win four games to move on to the next round. So if I only simulate three games, the worst record we could have is 0-3, and we would just have to win all four of the last ones. It's not super common, but yeah, we won the first game, okay, and won the second game, and best lines, okay, Penguins won the third game, but now we can, so if we lose two more, we're not out yet, but if we lose three, then we're out, so I'll simulate all the way up here, okay, we lost that game. So if we lose one more, we're out. So I'll just simulate one at a time. And we're out of the playoffs. Okay. Not a big deal for our first season. Nobody really expected us to do good. So the fact that we got into the playoffs should be an accomplishment. We're not always going to win. So now I'm just going to hit the sim to the draft button. And we're going to stop right there before the draft. So who won the Stanley Cup for this year, and then in the next video we will draft, and then we will sign contracts for the players we want to keep and release the players we don't want, and you guys can let me know stuff about that if you care, and then we will start the next season. So let's do goalies in the OHL for 6 weeks. Slowed down the simulation, the stats central where it shows who's winning the playoff games would be changing, but we're just going to simulate past it, and it will tell us who wins the Stanley Cup. So all right, we've sold almost 90% of all of our seats. We already updated our ticket prices, so we don't need to do it again. Okay, Stanley Cup champions was the Edmonton Oilers, and Calder Cup champions in the AHL was the Milwaukee Admirals. Okay, so next season, we will be able to spend $75 million, 75.9, and that's pretty much the only number that matters right there. Alright guys, so if you're still here, if you watched the entire almost hour and a half, I would be so to you guys who did. I appreciate you guys very much. I appreciate everybody, don't worry. But thank you guys, and be on the lookout for part two of this, and we will play the next season, and we will do the fun part, which is drafting and getting some good players. So thank you guys for watching. Look out for part two, and check out all my other videos if you haven't seen them. That would be awesome, and I will see you